Hello all, welcome back. We have been dealing with a very simple and beautiful poem by Khalil Gibran, The Song of a Flower.
And repeated by the voice of nature. I am a star fallen from the blue tent upon the green carpet. I am the daughter of the elements, with whom winter conceived, to whom spring gave birth. I was reared in the lap of summer, and I slept in the bed of autumn. At dawn I unite with the breeze to announce the coming of light. At eventide I join the birds in bidding the light farewell. The plains are decorated with my beautiful colors, and the air is scented with my fragrance. As I embrace slumber, the eyes of night watch over me, and as I awaken I stare at the sun, which is the only eye of the day. I drink dew for wine, and hearken to the voices of the birds, and dance to the rhythmic swaying of the grass. I am the lover's gift. I am the wedding wreath. I am the memory of a moment of happiness. I am the last gift of the living to the dead. I am a part of joy and a part of sorrow. But I look up high to see only the light, and never look down to see my shadow. This is wisdom which man must learn.
So, now we are going to discuss some poetic devices from the poem. Poetic devices from Song of the Flower. Here, blue tent upon the green carpet. What picture came to your mind when you read this line? Yes. Blue tent upon the green carpet. There is an image. It is created by using words. These type of mental images that are created using words are called visual images. Some other visual images from the poem. A star fallen, plains decorated with beautiful colors, the rhythmic swaying of the grass. I am a wedding wreath, my shadow. All these are examples of visual images from the poem. Then, the voice of the birds. I listen, I hearken to the voice of the birds. When you read this, can you hear the sound of the birds? Now, listen to this. Okay, now. Certain words that are used to create a sense of sound are called auditory images. The air is scented with my fragrance. In these lines, while you read this line, do you feel the smell of flowers? So creating the feel of smell using words is olfactory image. I drink dew for wine. Can you feel the taste of wine while reading this line? Yes. Creating a feel of taste or feel of something which is tasty using words or called gustatory image. And words that give a feel of touch are called tactile image. Next is metaphor. Metaphor is also a poetic device. It's a figure of speech. and it is used to compare one thing to other without the use of like or as. That is, it refers to something as being as the other. Some examples of metaphors from the poem: I am a star, I am the lover's gift, I am the wedding wreath, eyes of the nights, the eye of the day, blue tent, green carpet. I drink dew for wine. Does the flower drink dew or wine? Does the flower can drink? No, drinking is a human quality. But here, this human quality is given to a flower, which is an inhuman. So, giving human qualities to animals or objects called personification. Personification is also a figure of speech. Some examples of personification from the poem are: I unite with the breeze. I means here I refer to the flower. The flower says it unites with the breeze. Then the flower joins the birds. The flower embrace slumber. The flower drink, dance. All these qualities are human. They are associated with humans. But here they are given to an inhuman flower. Now read the lines. I am a star fallen from. Here the consonant sound F is repeated. Repetition of similar consonant sound are called alliteration. Repetition of the same consonant sound at the beginning of a word. With whom winter conceived. Here the W sound is repeated. With whom winter conceived. So, example of alliteration. Here, I drink dew for wine. In drink and dew, the D sound is repeated. So, all of you note down these examples from the poem and try to understand. We'll meet you in the next class with a new lesson. Thank you.